Good morning. Welcome to The Rep. I'm Chris Wooten with my friend and colleague, Micah Caskey, or my colleague at least, Micah Caskey.
Cold-blooded.
Shots fired early. So early.
Ready to get excited for you. You got third new vehicle.
I do.
Chris's auto lot out there.
Well, I just have a lot of friends. So this is the way it works in Wooten world. I paid off my truck last week. 2 days later, my transmission went out.
Ooh.
Ooh, yeah. So apparently that's happening to a lot of trucks that are just like mine, because you can't get a Chevrolet transmission for those trucks, so they can't find a brand new one. So I got a friend of mine, Hernan Chevrolet, shameless plug for David, and they're going to rebuild it for me. Custom rebuild for, I don't know, about $5,000. I don't know.
Pretty cheap.
I borrowed, I had a friend of mine say, well, man, I was talking to him about it, and he had the same problem. He said, well, I got a work van you can borrow. So I said, I'll drive a minivan for a few days. I'll do it. First of all, I drove it last night to the delegation meeting,
yeah.
And that's all. I parked at the very end of the parking lot when everybody saw me get out of it. But I've got carpool, right? I've got my daughter and her two little girls in the neighborhood that I have to take to school. Well, after I stopped in the driveway, I realized it doesn't have any back seats. So either I let the kids just float, because it's a work van. So he's taking all the seats out of the back. So
you just give the kids free candy to get inside.
I drive. It's tinted down. You can't see me. I got some ice cream music playing. No, anyway. So no, too
just,
soon, Brian.
Just tell you, too when soon. You show the jury a picture of that, you're guilty. It doesn't even matter what the crime is. You're going to prison.
Well, so another friend of mine, Craig Giles with Giles Insurance Agency. I'm giving them all this plug because they're helping me. He said that, man, my brother's got an excursion you can borrow. So he volunteered his brother's excursion. So now I'm driving another friend of mine's excursion, which, by the way, I don't want to seem like I'm not thankful, but he also had like a 70 Camaro in the driveway that I could have borrowed, but anyway, long story short, I'm driving somebody else's vehicle while I'm getting my...
Back to the Starbucks with a regular label there.
Well...
Or reserve status?
I had to get in and out pretty quick. I didn't realize I was downtown Columbia and I didn't have a mask on when I went into Starbucks.
And then you put it on later, right?
I said... So I got in and out pretty quick. I saw my head because I came across the river. And I'm going back across the river as fast as I can get there.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the show about transparency in government.
And I'm being very transparent.
You know what we should do today, though, instead of being negative, is we should talk about positive things in our community.
And the segue goes right into Micah. Micah, you've got some friends with us today that you brought on board. And I'd use that term loosely, ladies, if that's not true, because I know who brought you here. But would you like to introduce them?
In a bit. We don't want to rush into things. No, fortunate to have two representatives of the Habitat for Humanity, I guess the local group. I don't know what you call it. Local affiliate. So pull the microphone a little closer to you, Mary Louise, and pull your chair closer. I think that might be as far as it goes. I don't want to get the nomenclature wrong. So why don't you tell both of our listeners what you do and where you do it.
I'm Mary Louise Resch.
Come on, close it. There you go.
I am the Director of Philanthropy for Central South Carolina Habitat for Humanity, and with me today is...
I'm Nancy Lee. I'm the Executive Director with Habitat for Humanity South Carolina, and I support all of our local affiliates across the state.
So we've got local affiliate representation here in the Midlands and the statewide director. So the two ladies with all the answers, and as we get further in the program today, we're going to talk a bit about what Habitat for Humanity is doing and its plans going forward and all the different ways that it helps our community, not just the people who ultimately come to own and reside in the homes, but bring some goodwill, satisfaction, sense of efficacy, whatever.
Building community.
There we go. To people who get involved and support either through direct donation or in-kind donation through the hard work there.
Well, so this kind of makes me, I mean, thank you guys, first of all, for all the work you do. I just think about people that are doing work that sometimes there might be a simple answer to, that there's no simple answer to what you guys do because you are helping people that may not have an answer. So you're trying to provide for those. But so our former governor, Governor Beasley, who I worked for back, you know, years ago, I saw a little TikTok meme yesterday that I ended up sending to him because it was Sam Kinison, which was a comedian way back in the day. Right. And don't shake your head. You're giving your age away. Don't do that. So, but he said he was talking about feeding the hungry because, you know, David Beasley now is over the World Hunger.
World Food Program.
World Food Program. Yeah. So, so I sent him the meme. Sam Kinison says, I've got the answer. Let's not give them any more food. Let's give them U-Hauls. So we can get them out of there because you're living in a desert. There's nothing going to grow here. That's why there's no food. Get out of the desert and come with us. So I sent it to Beasley, and he sent, and all he sent me back was these like an emoji with the big eyes. So I don't know that he appreciated. Sometimes my humor gets missed. I don't really. Sometimes my humor is overlooked. I'm not really sure.
Huh. I don't know if humor is the word I would use to describe that one.
What was that? Then if it's not humor, because I was laughing. The whole time I sent it, I was
really
laughing.
Is that really the test for if it's humor or not? Christmas?
No, I laugh at things. I laugh at everything. I just like to laugh. I don't like to be negative, Micah. That's why we have these people today, because I come on here every week and I listen to your negativity. I leave here, I feel like I've been beaten up, so I just want good, positive energy today.
Well, good.
Good. So we're going to do
that. We've got the answer for you and all of our listeners across the world who've joined us to hear about Habitat for Humanity. We've only got a minute or so before we got to go to the break. Ladies, we are...
So we don't get too deep too early.
We get too deep too
early. Because usually we'll peak too soon.
Like, I can see the anticipation that you're ready to just say the thing. So if you want to, you can just say it now. Whatever you want.
Mary, go ahead. Tell us a little bit. Get us started, at least.
I want everybody to stay tuned because we're going to talk about some really great stuff that's happening here in Richland, Lexington, and Fairfield counties. And there's lots more good stuff coming up.
And we've got
that was good.
Yeah, well, that's a good tease. But we've got I've got some good friends that have you guys do mission trips. I don't know. There's a lot of things that go with that, and that's I don't know a ton about Habitat, so I'm very interested in finding out what all you've got going on too. So go ahead.
Yes, we do have Global Village trips. So those are mission trips that overseas. We build Habitat for Humanity builds internationally. Real kind of quick high level overview is Habitat for Humanity serves low to moderate income families. So what that means is 30% to 80% of the area median income. Mary Lee's will get into what that really means dollar value, but we help folks with first time home ownership. So we help them build their homes, get into a mortgage, have affordable, safe, stable housing. We also rehabilitate existing houses and we repair owner occupied houses for that same.
A good friend of mine, Wade McGuinn, you know, I've known Wade for 25 years or so, and he's been one of your guys' biggest proponents. He's, you know, he's gone on the trips. That's the reason I know what I know about it, so, you know, from that side. So.
And you're going to learn a lot more because most people think that we just build houses, but we do a whole lot more. And I'm seeing the countdown to break. So back up.
Well, we're going right into it. We'll find out a little bit more. Remember, if you need to call in, it's 803-799-TALK. Thanks for hanging out with us on The Rep. Welcome back. I'm Chris Wooten with Micah Caskey on The Rep. Thanks for hanging out with us on Wednesday morning. Before we get into anything else real quickly, just want to announce and can invite anybody that's listening that on October 5th, we're doing our Lexington County Heroes Breakfast over in Lexington at the Harvest Church. Doors open at 7:30. It's free entry. All you got to do is say thank you to a first responder because that's what it's all about. So that's October 5th at 7:30 at the Harvest Church on 378.
It's this will be our third annual breakfast, and I think people will come away from what we'll be announcing at that event with a lot of energy and enthusiasm for, you know, where things are headed.
Yeah, I'm excited.
Big reveal coming at the third annual Lexington County Heroes Breakfast. October
the radio
5th,
voice
7:30 a.m. in La Mañana.
We need to get Brian.
Bienvenidos. We should.
So, with that being said, our guest today, we actually
Habitat.
Do have a goal today.
And
I'm going to turn it over to you guys a little bit to tell us, to school us a little bit more.
Before we jump to all of the many virtues and that Habitat for Humanity brings to the community, as we alluded to earlier, and, growing, supporting home ownership and that, why don't we start with a little bit of your backgrounds and I'll make it weird because we'll go with Nancy first. Throw them off.
All right.
Sometimes I
reverse. Are you going to do it like you did last night at the delegation? You got a minute or less, and you're going to cut her off?
Uh-uh.
Okay.
I'm going to need a big timer if we're doing that.
No, we're not doing that.
I can talk for forever.
Sometimes I change like where my dog's bowls are, like put the food on one side and then I flip it to the other. And
See, Brian? And you got on me last week for not caring about dogs?
You won't even pray for dogs. All right.
I don't pray for dogs. So I'm not going to pray for. I'll pray for you if you're experiencing problems.
Right.
Segue.
Right.
I'm going to go back to the hero's breakfast and say thank you for that. I am the daughter of a volunteer fireman. So
oh, great.
I grew up going on calls, and kind of the rule was as long as I was in his truck and didn't say anything when the tones went off before he got in, I was allowed to go.
That's awesome.
Having a 3-year-old now, my mind as a mom goes to, did my mom not, did she just assume that I was always with him because we didn't have cell phones? Was she not just worried when I was gone for 5 hours at a time? But that's, kind of segue into that's how
well,
I
that kind
got,
of tells us how you got here.
Right,
it's all about
right.
service.
I grew up around service. My sister, her husband are both in the Army. Actually met at Camp Liberty in Baghdad years ago. I don't know, 10 years ago now, 11 years ago. But just grew up around a family of service and have always wanted to give back. So fast forward, it's been 16 years. I've been working in the nonprofit field and have been with Habitat for Humanity, I think maybe 8 or 9 years now.
Wow.
Worked in Richmond, Virginia, assisted some with the Veterans Build team in D.C. with some of their work partnering, and in Charleston. And now I'm in Columbia supporting the state level.
And then what? What are you pointing?
I was just pointing. I thought that hand and arm signal was clear for share your microphone
guess,
with her
guess,
because
guess,
we were having a
guess.
Little
okay. Well,
a little connection issue there.
All right, well, let me
defer.
All right, here we go.
But we're
right.
now yeah. turning towards Mary Louise.
As I said earlier, I'm Mary Louise Resch. I work with Central South Carolina Habitat. I've been there a little over 2 years. And I want to also thank you both for recognizing those unsung heroes as a veteran. Having spent 9 years in the Army, I know sometimes we don't always get a thank you, so thank you. And I've been in the nonprofit sector for about 35 years. I have done everything from dropout prevention to feeding the hungry. I spent 8 years at Harvest Hope Food Bank before I came to Habitat. And people ask me why I stayed in the nonprofit sector so long, and it's because money's nice, but it's not the only benefit. And I find what I've done over the years has made a bigger difference than any big paycheck. Not to say that I don't mind getting my check every 2 weeks.
Well, tell us a bit about the work that you're doing over there or that the affiliate as a whole is doing for people who may not be as familiar with Habitat for Humanity or even more unfamiliar than Chris.
Well, when we talk to people about Habitat, everybody thinks of Jimmy Carter and building houses. We now talk about Tricia Yearwood, Garth Brooks, and reviving neighborhoods. Actually, we are both in Richland and Lexington counties right now. We are building one. We're rehabbing a house in Irmo. We have a new build in Lexington and a rehab in Lexington. For those of you who live in Lexington, do you remember the old house that's behind the Jim Hudson dealership? I encourage you to drive by it now because it looks entirely different. And the reason that we're so concerned about affordable home ownership, you notice we don't say affordable housing, is that in Lexington County, the average rent for a 1,400 square foot apartment is $1,350 a month. Families who go through our program, and that's the other misconception. Everybody thinks that people just show up at your doorstep, we hand them a set of keys, say congratulations, you're a homeowner. It's actually completely different.
They spend an average of 18 months to 2 years in the program. They have to work with a financial counselor throughout that time, reducing their debt. They have to put away $75 a month towards their closing costs. They have to attend 13 mandatory classes on everything from home repair to being a good neighbor. And they have to do a minimum of 300 hours of sweat equity on other people's properties, working in our restore or working in our office. And that's before they ever break ground on their own house. So as you can see, it's a lot more than just showing up at our door and handing you a set of keys.
And I apologize if this is a non sequitur, but the folks who then come to own these homes or live in the homes, you know, where does that process begin? Where does that eligibility, you know, get determined? Like, how does that even start?
Every January, we do a series of education programs where people can come and learn about coming in the program. With COVID, we've had to modify that slightly. So one of our sessions is actually a virtual session that we do online. What they will do, and what's interesting is we'll get a room full of people, and then about halfway through, people will get up and leave because they realize the program's not free and you have to work and you have to commit. Of those who are interested, they have to do a large they have to give us all of their expenses, all of their day-to-day costs. We look at their finances. We actually have volunteers from our board that do home visits to actually see the real need. And for example, you have a family that is in an apartment. You have a mom and three kids that are in an apartment, two-bedroom apartment, and then you've got another family. You got a mom and three kids that are living out of the back seat of the car. So, you know, need is at, and I see you shaking your head. It happens more frequently than you imagine.
Well, Mary, let me jump in there real quick. People, what we don't understand a lot of times, especially in our community, like in Lexington, if you live, you know, where I am in the Hope Ferry area, Corley Mill area, River Bluff High School, you see, I mean, it's the lake community. You don't think about it, and you don't even know it's there until you get involved. But, you know, when I was coaching at River Bluff, there were several times, and I one just really vividly in my mind, of a kid coming to practice one day, and he's walking to practice, and I see him walking down the side of Corley Mill Road. So I'm like, well, why is he walking? I'll call him Billy just for namesake. But why is he walking to, you know, practice? You think about everybody's got to ride to practice or whatever. He's walking down Corley Mill Road. So I stop and I pick him up, and we're on the way. And come to find out, long story short, he and his mom are living in a car. And because their room at the hotel where they were staying, they didn't have any more money for it. But the kids still come to football. So we don't think about things like that in our community when you're just going into day-to-day life. So it really takes some folks to get outside of the box to see what you know why you're doing what you're doing.
Well, and Mary Louise, you mentioned all the different steps and prerequisites and requisites to get in the program and then stay in the program. You know, it really sounds like a quintessential example of a hand up rather than a hand out. And I guess my question to you, Nancy, would be is Mary Louise talks about how it operates here in the Midlands. Is that the same in other parts of the state?
It is, yes. Every affiliate, every county is going to be a little bit different based on what the need is in that county or that municipality, but it Habitat's model operates the same. So in some counties, you'll see where we're building more new homes. In some counties, you'll see where we're repairing homes that are owner-occupied. So this might be an elderly family who, over time, they're on a fixed income now. And, to be honest, when I was in Central Virginia, I walked into a home. It was a couple weeks before Christmas, and there was a hole in the ceiling, and it had been snowing. So wow. You've got that, and so you're wanting to make sure that you're addressing the whole continuum of housing and stability.
Well, and I'll echo that. When I worked for the town of Lexington, we did some work with the Community Development Block Grant in West Lexington, and I can remember walking into a house doing a home inspection, and here's the floor, and it's already sloping, and then you look up above the sink, and there's a gap of about 2 inches, and this person is still living in this house.
Wow. For those who just maybe tuned in, we're talking this morning with representatives from Habitat for Humanity, Nancy Lee and Mary Louise Resch, here sharing some information about the wonderful work that's going in, going on here in the Midlands area and statewide. So for those of you who maybe wanted to hear another exciting COVID recycled discussion on the rep this morning, very sorry, but we're trying to be more positive today.
Well, and to let you know, we're not in session, so there's not a lot other than COVID, same old conversation of mask or no mask, vaccinations, no vaccination. But today, actually, we've got a caucus meeting, you know, when we were talking about, since this is supposed to be about transparency in government to start off with, is because we've got a caucus meeting today to address some of the Biden administration's issues that they've just thrown at from a federal government standpoint, that South Carolina has said we're not going to take a stand for, hopefully, and we find some common ground on this thing, but to mandate vaccines for people with 100 employees or more and some of those things. So that's actually what we've got coming down the pipe today. So anyway, if you want to call in and give us a shout or on any of those issues, always welcome, no matter what we've got going on it on the Groucho's Daily phone line, 803-799-TALK, 803-799-8255. But right now, we're still continuing the conversation with our folks from Habitat for Humanity. As we come back, we'll get a little bit more into what that means and
how you can help.
Yeah, and actually how you can help put all that together.
So get your credit card. We're ready.
Hey. All right, thanks for hanging out with us on the rep. Welcome back to the rep.
As
officer tries to explain to the enlisted man what it's like to work. I appreciate your chance to do that. I appreciate your attempt to do that.
I don't mind working
for you. And it's like, you know, it's like someone that's never been a veteran saying thank you for your service. They don't. It's a lot of times people don't. Not all the time. People don't know what that actually means. So for you to say work, maybe you know, maybe you don't. I don't know, but that's okay.
Says the guy who wrote speeding tickets for a job.
I didn't write a lot of speeding tickets. I hated writing speed tickets. I hated writing speed tickets.
I appreciate your service.
No, I'd pull you over for speeding, but I find something else to write your ticket for if I wanted to write you. Depends on what your attitude was a lot of times, Micah. Now you, we might have had a little talk. So anyway, back to our positive show today.
Positive.
Because I'm pretty positive you'd have got a ticket. So with that being said, back to our folks from Habitat for Humanity. Guys, Micah, you were leading into.
We were talking about different. We'd kind of gone through, you know, some of the work that they're doing and outlining the types of work, I guess, that they've done and some of the impact that it's having here on the Midlands. And I think, you know, I guess front of mind, though, is also as this is all going on, how much has the pandemic, as much as we do hate to have to recycle that conversation, I'm curious as to what impact COVID has had on you guys.
Actually, it's been kind of interesting. During the depths of the pandemic, our office was actually closed only 2 weeks. But even during those 2 weeks, we were working remotely. Habitat has a partnership with South Carolina Emergency Management. I've been a member of the State Emergency Response Team for 6 years. And when it came time to distribute PPE to nonprofits, we stepped up. We have a warehouse. Nancy did it at the state level. And we distributed locally about $750,000 worth of PPE to date. And I still have hand sanitizer and masks in my office for nonprofits that I'm still waiting to come in. And Nancy, how much has that been at the state level?
It's been close to $2 million distributed thus far, and like Mary Louise said, we still have some supplies, and we actually have some that we're working on getting down to a Habitat affiliate in Louisiana for Hurricane Ida response. So it's something that's certainly needed in order for nonprofits to continue working. And, you know, we've been doing this since June, I think, of May or June, might have been earlier, May of 2020, we'll say, for easy math. But, and you know, you're talking about the impact of what we've seen. Last year across the state, we had delays on about 92 home builds, 26 home closings. Just you think of when certain lockdowns were happening or just folks working remotely, it would be hard to get folks, municipalities to come out to pull permits or do right. inspections. So even those small things could put us behind. That being said, and even having about, I want to say it was a little more than a third of the volunteers we typically have on site, again, statewide, we still saw an increase of our home production by about 100 homes. So we went from building, rehabbing, repairing 230-ish homes every year to last year being over 330. We're seeing the need is increasing. As Mary Louise mentioned earlier, you hear a lot about rental needs, and we certainly believe in the housing continuum and making housing affordable for all walks of life and all financial situations. But it's interesting, in South Carolina, a two-bedroom apartment is unaffordable in 40 of our 46 counties. And if you look across, that's consistent nationwide, where about two-thirds, it's cheaper, and this is not even counting Habitat's model, which is more affordable than on the buying on the open market. But across the nation, it is more affordable to own your home in two-thirds of the counties in the nation. So it's interesting that there is certainly a place for renting, but we don't want to discount the stability that comes with home ownership, both from a financial position. And so many folks think, oh, it's long term and it's asset building. And sure, yes, it is. But it's also, if you don't have to move apartments every year, you're not having to have new security deposits. You're not having to take time off work to move. You're not, and we say security deposits for the apartment that you're in, for, you know, your utilities, for your mm-hmm. internet, for your water, et cetera. There's a lot that goes into that. And so it keeps kids in a single, you know, school system. It keeps them stable. It keeps employment more stable. So there's a lot of benefits.
Not only that, but people forget that Habitat is actually a business. We hire subcontractors that come and do like our roofs and our plumbing and our air conditioning. So we're contributing to the economy that way. We use volunteers, which typically save us at least $100,000 a year in labor costs. But we're also part of the community, and our families, they go from paying rent to no more than paying one-third of their family gross family income, which on average is about $450 to $500 here in the Midlands.
Wow. So let me ask you this, because you mentioned volunteers. Surely is any, you know, not-for-profit organization that is trying to do good in the community, you need help and support in so many ways. And what are those ways, and how can people get involved?
Great question, Micah. First of all, I encourage you to go to our website, which is www.habitatcsc.org. Again, that's www.habitatcsc.org. We have a link to our volunteer page where you can sign up to volunteer either on a construction site or in our restore. And by the way, go visit our restore at 2814 Augusta Road in West Columbia. It is open to the public. That's another misconception. And if you're sitting with your iPhone, I see iPhones here in the room. If you really want to not wait, you can text HOMECSC to 44321 and make a tax-deductible contribution to Habitat.
Wait, say that number again for all the people who want to text donate?
It's HOMECSC to 44321.
44321. All right.
That's the number.
Okay. Got it. Text home SC to 44321.
Home CSC.
Home CSC. All right.
Say it three times.
Nope. Not confusing anybody.
So, Mary, just so you know, that laugh, that giggle as you were in your serious conversation was not for you. That was for Brian's face as he drank the C4 that Micah brought him today as they continue the quest to find the perfect energy drink for the perfect show, as Micah brings a new one every week and they're testing things out. So I'd just like to ask the question, since we're not on the topic. Do you know what's in it, and why are you putting it in your body? That's all I'm asking.
I have never held that to as the standard for decisions of my, you know, consumption or injection. I've never been like, hey, you know what I need to know is if this has, for example, carnosine, well, which is a registered trademark, which means that is absolutely made up.
which means all you had to do is fill out a piece of paper, look, and send it in, and they'll register it.
Hey.
They'll register it like Chris. I'll sign in trademark Chris Wooten. Put it in. I'll get a piece of paper back with a trademark on that.
Hey,
look, with a circle.
Fitness guy. Zero calories. So it's got to be good.
It's got to be good.
It's got to be good.
It's good. I mean, it's zero calories. How can it be bad for you?
Zero calories. Yeah.
You know what else has zero calories? Water.
Not necessarily.
Yeah,
they make fitness water.
They, now if you doctor calories. It, if you doctor it up, it's a little different.
Put your sugar in your water.
Yeah,
you can have Kool-Aid or fitness water.
My kids used to laugh at me all the time. Now they do it. It's so hilarious because I always order water. I drink water. I don't drink anything other than water and coffee, milk, whatever. I don't typically. Well, I mean, except for ball games. Not, I mean, except tailgating. So. But typically my daily routine is I drink just water. You know, I drink a little bit of caffeine here and there. But if we go out to eat, I always order water with a lemon, and then I put some Sweet and Low in it, and I make a little redneck lemonade. And my kids used to laugh at me all the time. Now it would go somewhere, and I look over, and they're opening up their little packets, putting some saccharin, putting some lemonade in it. So, yeah, I'm a little frugal. Wow. You know how much drinks cost?
I do. Yeah. I do know.
Yeah.
Although I only order water. What I got?
Well, and on the other side of that, sometimes when you
just virtue signaling,
I started doing that when I was stationed up in D.C. When I was stationed up in D.C. because the water was so horrible.
Oh, that's
because, you know, they put so much chlorine, I guess, or whatever in it. I don't know what they do, but it's probably not calorie free up there. But with that being said, I started doing that just to kind of get rid of the taste.
And with all of those savings, you could make that donation to Habitat for Humanity at
44321
Home. CSC?
Yes.
Whoa. Nailed it.
Bam, we got it.
What was the website? What was the website again, Mary Louise?
www.habitatcsc.org.
Habitatcsc.org.
Yeah.
And you can help other people. Those of you who are not
we got 2 minutes. You don't have
right
to stretch
now.
Your words out right now. We got 2 minutes. We're good.
Who are not working
we're good.
At 9:42 on a Wednesday, you can spend
some Andy, I know you're listening. Text 44321 on your flip phone to, I'm sorry, Andy. You know
home
you're out there.
CSC.
You know, yeah, I love you. All right. So we talked about how folks can get involved. What do you have to do? I mean, if someone is in a situation where they're actually interested in either application or in a struggle situation, you know, how can someone actually, you know, who do they talk to? Who do they get involved with?
Again, I'm going to send you to the website, which is habitatcsc.org.
Well, I will say this, because I didn't know this. There again, living where I live and the schools and the things we have, everybody doesn't have internet, right? In South Carolina, we just put a lot of money into some broadband-ish things that we can do. So what if someone doesn't have that availability, just for conversation's sake, just to pull that in?
They can also dial, and I'm sorry I had to look this up because I don't dial our office a lot. It's 803-252-3570. Again, it's 803-252-3570. And if you're interested in the home ownership program, you're going to speak to Emily, who is our home ownership family services manager.
So, you know, once you, I guess, if you're trying to volunteer with that, we'll get into that a little bit more of what all in our next segment. We've got another segment left, but just to kind of how can you volunteer? What all opportunities are there to do what, you know, to volunteer, traveling, whatever it might be. But we're going to hop into a break here in about 10 seconds, so we won't get into it yet. But I'll just, for now, as we lead into the break, I'll just say that I still don't know why Micah doesn't wear socks with those shoes. Have no clue.
Transparency in government. Ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back.
as we continue with our folks with Habitat for Humanity. There's some interesting programs out there that it's not just about building houses for communities or folks. It is there's a ton of different programs that you guys have, and I'm anxious to hear about some of them as you know we get into this just a little bit deeper, because it gets more interesting the more you talk about it. Because if you talk about Habitat for Humanity, people, you know, a lot of people are so busy these days. They're running around, well, I don't have time to go build a house. We don't have to go build a house to help out, you know. Right. And if you, you know.
I think that's where my preconception of Habitat for Humanity, just because I, you know, you see the company, you know, outing bonding day and they go build a house or whatever. And,
right.
And that's really was the limit of my knowledge of what Habitat for Humanity does until I spent a day with our local affiliate and toured their facility for, you know, they have all like a, I don't know, carpentry shop? I don't know what you call it.
Yeah.
Woodworking shop where they're working on various things that actually need to go into the house and help speed up or accelerate the rehabilitation process, and then got to tour some of the work that was being done for these homes. So,
and I just handed Chris our before and after, since you've seen these for real, but he hasn't. I just gave him a packet of photos that show the before and after in our neighborhood. And Nancy, you want to tell him a little bit more about our neighborhood revitalization and repair program?
Yes. So to your point, a lot of folks think of Habitat and building new homes, and we certainly do a lot of that. But it's interesting. Over the past 3 years now, a little over 60% of our home production has been owner-occupied repairs. And so alluded to that a little bit earlier, that's when somebody owns their own home, but they're unable. There might be some issues. There's been flooding if they're in a disaster area. Certainly, Columbia can. We're still recovering from the flood in certain areas. You have that where you're going in fixing roof, or it's a accessibility situation where you're widening door frames, or you're putting in a ramp, or you're lowering kitchen countertops. So you have that going on, and then there's also the rehabilitation of homes, and these are homes that already exist, but they don't have anybody living in them. They are sitting vacant, and so very similar to our home, our new builds, we're going in with volunteers and with subcontractors and revitalizing those so we can put a new family in them at the no-interest mortgage and affordable mortgage monthly payment price point. So it's essentially what the neighborhood revitalization, though, is we're going in one block at a time and saying that it's not always a new build that's needed, that sometimes it's taking care of those homes that are already there and making sure that we maintain those properties, that we bring them up to a level that folks can use them, they can live in them, they're safe, they're not, you know, certainly Mary Louise, I'm sure, has seen this too in certain and flood-prone areas. You'll go in and, you know, there's black mold everywhere, and that's not safe. Certainly in a year and a half where we've been talking about health, that's top of mind for folks a lot more now, but we see that a lot at Habitat. So we want to go in and make sure that we are making housing available to families.
And some of the side benefits that we didn't even realize that we were making, in one of our neighborhoods in Caskey, there we were doing some builds and repairs on houses that until we gave the chief of public safety the ride, he explained to us that street had a mandatory two-officer response because he couldn't guarantee the officer sending one officer down that street. Long story short. That street's crime has reduced 70%. And
wow.
And now kids can ride their bikes and families can walk out on the street.
That's awesome. I think we got a caller on the line. Karen, good morning. Welcome to the rep.
Hey, let me ask you guys a question, because I'm still laying in the bed. I have to get ready for work, and I'm not really listening to the station, and I work weird hours. But I just want to put in a concern I have. I've called Joe Wilson's office. I was served for jury duty yesterday. They asked a health questionnaire in there saying that you might be required to prove medical documentation. But I have to have a doctor's appointment, so I called my doctor. They ain't going to put anything other than I was present there. That's against your HIPAA violation. But I just wanted to put in a comment, because I do listen to Kevin Cohen, and I just work hours that I can't listen to the point around 5 o'clock because I'm at work. but I just feel that's against your HIPAA violation, and that's just terrible because the Republicans, they blame the Democrats for being in everybody's business. This is a Republican state, and they're doing the same thing, sir. That's not, you know, asking you, will you, won't you wear a mask? No, I'm not wearing a mask. This stuff about your stuff, and then they say that at the end of the questionnaire, they say you might have to show medical documentation. That's wrong.
I don't know. First of all, that's a great question for Kevin. Secondly,
Back about, you know, 4 or 5 or so this afternoon, 803-799-TALK.
But I don't know actually that I understood the exact question.
It was a concern.
She
was concerned about the revelation or disclosure of medical information and as it pertains to jury selection vis-a-vis your doctor's office. So, Karen, I appreciate the call. Thank you for voicing that concern.
Thank you.
Yep. So back to our Habitat folks before we get out of here. How can folks get a little more involved in not just hammering and doing plumbing? What else can you do?
Real expert on work over there.
I'll tell you what. Plumbing's a technical trade. If somebody wants to help out with plumbing, we will.
I'm taking the mic back. I'm finishing. I don't want anyone to talk to any one of you.
We're ready. Gotcha.
Look. From the guy, no, I'm not even going to start because I'm going to be respectful because I want actually good stuff to come out of this. We got next week. I don't forget.
44321 Home SC. CSE, Home CSE.
Right. So as far as getting involved, there's all sorts of things you can do to volunteer. Certainly you can come out and help build a house. But as Mary Louise talked about, we have volunteers that help us with our homeowner selection program. We have folks that help us with our budgeting. We have a lot of mortgage professionals, mortgage bankers, mortgage lenders. Well, say that and I think of banks. But the representatives that work at banks that come out and they help us with budgeting. So, you know, you see jokes on, you were talking about TikTok and Twitter and everything earlier. You see memes all the time that, you know, need to teach people how to balance their checkbook or, you know, do their taxes. It's interesting that with Habitat, our program, we are going through and making sure that even beyond that it's the basic, all right, you know, how much of your income should be going to housing. Funny story here that's kind of sad. When I bought my first house, I was a few years out of college, and I didn't have bad credit. I just had no credit. Still not sure why they gave me a mortgage when I use, I'll tell my age here a little bit, my Blockbuster card, and I had just gotten out of college. So in my tanning bed history, they used that to help me justify that I would make payments on time.
And that's how we got a housing crisis.
I will say that was exactly that. Mine, when I was young and I didn't know about 30%, you know, that you should only spend 30%. So there's little things that, and I grew up with, you know, a two-parent household, and I to this day, I don't have a credit card. My dad, if we didn't have the money, then we didn't buy it. But it's little things that I didn't know certain details. So we have opportunities for volunteer all across the board, not just on a build site.
Good. And of course, I the reality with the work that you do and really with the work that most folks do in service to others, there is a financial component to it all that requires financial contributions. So there are some people who are listening now who have the means, and I know you would benefit and put those dollars to good use because they are hard to come by, right? It is hard to raise money and do that so you can continue to do the good work. And what was the website address again?
www.habitatcsc.org. Or we've talked about our community revitalization rides. If they'd like to schedule one, they can call me at 803-992-9707. And we'll be happy to put you in a construction truck and actually take you out to one of our sites where we're working. So you don't have to take our word for it. You can actually see it for yourself. And Micah, you've been on that ride.
I have. And I can offer a personal testimonial to the truth of that. It is when you see the community revitalization taking place, because sometimes it's easy when you're in an area that you don't, you know, live in or drive through often to just sort of take that straight line across and be done with it in a minute or so. But when you slow down and kind of go through the community and look at all the houses, and you see the systematic approach that Habitat for Humanity has adopted in terms of its program, how that begins to transform the area, again, not just for those folks who now are coming into home ownership and all of the benefits that accrue there, but as you mentioned, there's a public safety component to a lot of this as well, because as we know, people who care about their neighborhood make decisions that make the neighborhood a better place in all this.
Why, when you talk about taking a different route and looking at a different street, or you continue to point at me, like, just because I live on one side of Lexington and I don't, like, get out of my box too much? I mean, I got everything I need within, like, 2 miles of me. I don't go across the interstate unless I come over here. I don't go past the high school. I don't go across the dam. Why should I?
get a new transmission for one.
No, I don't have to. It's in my district. I give money back to the people in my district. Hey, well, thanks for hanging out with us a little bit on the rep today. We appreciate you. Don't forget, for the from our folks for Habitat for Humanity, please check out their website. Make sure that you can, if you want to help out, I'm sure they'll find you a way to do that. We appreciate you guys taking time and all the good work that you do, because obviously the majority of your folks are enlisted people and not officers and know how to work. So I appreciate that, and we got to go. Thanks. Good night. God bless.